So when we government killed him, we started to dig and we found the bones of the policeman still in the uniform. And so we had to take him out. I said, go and take him out. The mayor of Iloilo City, I identified him. This is broadcast. I said, you're next.
Saan ang mayor ninyo dito? Saan yung pinagitan mo, mayor? Saan ba si mayor? Hinabi ko sa kanila, balik ka dito. Patayin talaga kita.
Hindi lamang po ito basta-basta pagbabanta. Kayang-kaya niya pong totohanin ito. Labag man sa kalooban, kinailangan po naming lumisan at wag na munang bumalik sa Pilipinas. On August 28, 2017, I received an unexpected call from former PNP Regional Director Bernardo Diaz. He invited me to meet with PNP Chief Ronald De La Rosa, now Senator, at Camp Crame, Quezon City, at noon the following day. The next morning, on August 29, I arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport at 10 a.m., ready to proceed. But then the call started. First, they moved the meeting to 3 p.m., and then by 5 p.m., it was delayed again, this time to 6 p.m. At around 5 p.m., a PNP colonel called me and in a voice that sent shivers down my spine, literal po yun, warned me not to go to Camp Crame because my life was in danger. The fear that had been simmering now erupted. Soon after, at 6:32 p.m., my wife, Marivic, received a chilling text from a PNP colonel's wife, "Do not proceed. There are 20 men surrounding your house, and if you go to Camp Crame, they will kill you." The terror was paralyzing. I couldn't believe it. My life and my family's life was hanging by a thread. The next day, on August 30, I took the first flight out to Japan, not knowing if I would ever return. Upon arrival, I received a message from General Diaz to call a number. Using a public payphone, I made the call and spoke to General Bato, who expressed his sympathy. He was talking to me in Bisaya. He told me he knew I was innocent, that I wasn't involved in illegal drugs, and he promised to help me. His words brought a brief moment of hope. I told him I would finish my work abroad and return to meet him, but he urged me to be careful repeating his pledge to help. Just after that call, my Philippine cell phone rang. This time, it was another general. His voice was grim. "Mayor, do not return. Your life is in danger. The accusations against you are all fabricated. But if you go to Crame, you'll be forced to point fingers to an opposition senator and a former presidential candidate as drug lords." The weight of the conspiracy against me was unbearable. This general couldn't live with the guilt of seeing me killed, he said, and warned me to destroy my Philippine SIM card and phone immediately, and told me because my phone is going to be wiretapped. My hands trembled, as I realized how close death had come. I knew then that I was no longer just a target. I was in a battle for my life. Dumiretso po kami sa US at nag-apply ng political asylum. Mapalad po kami na pinagkalooban kami ng US ng political asylum. It took 15 months for them to investigate and see the validity of us not being involved in illegal drugs, and all these accusations are all false. Ito ay isang patunay na walang nakitang kadahilanan na ibinigyan kami ng political asylum in March 2019. Masakit at malungkot, ngunit napilitan akong lumisan mula sa aking sinumpaan tungkulin sa aking pamilya at sa kababayan kong Ilonggo na sinumpaan kong pagsilbihan, hindi dahil sa nagkasala ako, kundi dahil nanganganib na po ang aming buhay. I come before you today not merely to recount my sufferings, but to highlight a critical flaw in our system, one that allows law enforcement agencies to be weaponized for political purposes. That illegal drug trade stems from the ills of our society, from poverty to corruption of government institutions, including our law enforcement agencies. By using state institutions to carry out personal vendettas or silence perceived enemies, undermine the foundation of justice and democracy in our country. Sideline. No individual should be allowed to wield such unchecked authority regardless of their position or power. Ang karanasan at ng iba pang mga katulad kong biktima, lalong-lalo na ang mga mayors na pinagbintangan, ay ang nagmulat sa amin sa mga pagkukulang at kakulangan ng ating law enforcement agencies. Kailangan mapatibay pa ang mga institusyon ito upang hindi basta-basta magamit o maimpluwensya ng politika. Masigurong makakapagsilbi ng may integridad, walang kinikilingan at may respeto sa batas. Ang panawagan po namin sa inyo, manguna po ang hustisya at magkaroon ng reforma sa ating sistema, partikular sa pamamalakad ng ating law enforcement agencies. Accusations must be duly validated and authenticated first before any public announcement to avoid shaming and destroying the honor, reputation, and good image of hardworking and innocent persons. Higit sa lahat, panagutin ang mga umaabuso sa kapangyarihan. Sana ang nadanasan naming paghihirap na durog na durog, persecution, trauma, at saka walang wala ay hindi po mararanasan ng iba. At mananaig ang katotohanan at hindi ang pamumulitika o personal na interes ng ilan. Absensya na po. Maraming salamat po sa Quad Committee dahil 7 taon po. Nahihirap talaga po. Maraming salamat dahil napigyan niyo po kami, ako, at ang iba pang mga biktima ng pagkakataon na linisin ang aming mga pamangalan at na mga minamahal ko, Ilonggo at yung Iloilo na tinawag po Shabulized. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Dakbanwas ang Iloilo. Bugal ko, my city, my pride. I am Iloilo. Proud to be Filipino po. Salamat po.